Hi everyone, I'm Shira.
And I'm Matt.
And today we're going to be talking about the 10th principle of green chemistry, which is to design chemicals for degradation. This principle states that chemical products should be designed so that at the end of their function, they break down into innocuous degradation products that don't persist in the environment.
What that means is that we want chemicals to degrade into molecules that are not harmful to humans, animals, or the environment. The majority of chemicals we use in our day-to-day life need to be stable in order to perform their main function. For example, if a coffee mug dissolved when you poured coffee into it, it wouldn't be very useful.
Or if lubricants degraded under high pressures or temperatures, they may not work well in the engines of our cars or planes.
But what happens to these chemicals after they are done providing their main function? They might end up in a landfill or a wastewater treatment plant. From there, they can enter the water, soil, and air of our environment, or be taken up by humans and animals.
The biggest challenge is making chemicals that are stable during usage but do not persist in the environment, or in other words, can be degraded. Another big thing is we want the degradation products to be non-toxic and also not persist.
It's important to remember that there are many reasons why a chemical can degrade. It can be due to reactions with light, known as photodegradation, water, known as hydrolysis, or with biological species, often enzymes, which is called biodegradation.
You've probably heard about biological degradation a lot in the news. For example, I think we've all heard about biodegradable soaps, right? So why don't we use biodegradable soaps or detergents as an example about how we can make chemicals that are more easily degradable in the environment?
This molecule is called sodium dodecyl benzene sulfonate, or LAS for short. Looking at its structure, you can see it has a linear alkyl chain with a benzyl sulfonate group attached to it. It's used as a detergent because it has a polar head group, the sulfonate, and a nonpolar alkyl chain, making it a surfactant.
LAS is used in many things, especially in laundry detergents. It's able to break down in the environment under aerobic conditions or when oxygen is present. Microbes are able to use the linear alkyl chain as energy via a process called beta oxidation, which breaks down the carbon chain. Once the long chain has been degraded, the rest of the molecule can be degraded as well.
If you compare LAS to the branch version, you can immediately see that the alkyl chain looks very different. This molecule was also used as a detergent just like the linear version, but because of the location of the branches, microbes cannot perform beta oxidation because there are no good sites for the reaction to be initiated. Therefore, these branch detergents have been phased out of most developed countries because of their persistence.
The main way these molecules break down is through microbes when oxygen is present. So if they end up directly in water, for example straight into a lake, they'll degrade more slowly, even the linear versions, because there are less microbes in water than in soil.
Interestingly, the branch version is 4 times less toxic than the linear version, but can cause more damage because of its persistence. This is why it is very important to consider a molecule's persistence or its resist to degradation and not just its toxicity.
You can see how designing chemicals to break down can be very challenging, but many researchers around the world are working on this right now. One example is biodegradable polymers that are used in plastics, for example, compostable cutlery.
Principle 10 is currently one of the largest challenges in green chemistry. If scientists designing new chemicals can understand more about the mechanisms that degrade them, we may be able to make new chemicals that are stable for their desired usage, but break down in the environment.
Thank you for watching. Be sure to like this video and subscribe to see the rest of our series on the principles of green chemistry. If you want to learn more about the Green Chemistry Initiative, check us out at our website or on Facebook or Twitter.